I've seen them and I think they're great for traveling. Another thing that a lot of our guests ask us is about money. How much to bring? Are euros accepted? You can't just tab it onto your credit card bill like you can, say, back in North America. One thing I would not suggest bringing. Hi everybody, welcome back to our channel. I'm Sarah, a Canadian that's been living in Croatia now for 10 years. Today I thought I'd do a quick video about what to pack on your travels to Croatia, because pretty much all of our guests who come here ask us if there's anything specific they should pack, and just kind of a packing list. So I thought this video might be helpful to all of those who are planning a trip to Croatia in the near future. And so I hope that this is helpful. So let's get started right away. First things first, obviously clothes. It's summertime here, so if you're coming in the summer, easy stuff, shorts, t-shirts, and dresses. I like dresses because they're just super simple to pack. They pack small, and you can wear them in the day, in the evening, and they're just really versatile. So I always pack a bunch of dresses. On that note, you can pack something a little nicer for dinners, because there are some really, really nice restaurants you can go to all over the country. So maybe pack like one nicer outfit just to go out to a nice dinner if you want to. Obviously not necessary, but if you would like. The next thing I would advise you to bring is just like some kind of extra layer. If you're coming in the summertime, you might not even need it, but it's always good just to have one extra layer. I usually just bring a cardigan. You can also bring like a light wind or rain jacket. It can get cool sometimes in the evenings, sometimes not at all, but better safe than sorry. Just bring an extra layer of some sort. Obviously, if you're traveling in the spring, fall, and winter, you're gonna want warmer clothes, but this is more geared to summer season traveling, so I'm not gonna tell you what to bring for clothes. You guys can, I'm sure, figure out the appropriate clothes for summer, fall, spring, and winter, but this is more like for summer packing. Next, obviously, bring a hat, don't forget, and sunglasses, don't forget those. And then on the note with sun, just bring a bunch of sunscreen with you, because the sun is strong, you'll be by the sea most likely, and so protect your skin, bring your sunscreen. And also with sunscreen, if you don't bring it from home, that's fine. There are obviously places to buy it here, so you don't have to worry. You can get them in kind of like drugstore shops like Dam and Bipa. Miller has them also. Just a lot of stores, grocery stores, you can get sunscreen everywhere. So if you don't bring it, don't worry. We've got you covered in Croatia. Next thing is, of course, your toiletries bag. Don't forget that. Whatever you've got in there, your toothbrush, toothpaste, makeup, whatever is in there. Obviously, don't forget that. But if you forget anything, you can buy it here. Don't worry. Next thing on the list is your chargers. Don't forget your chargers. And on the topic of chargers, you can buy, I'm sure a lot of your devices have like a USB charger. You can just buy like a USB end that goes into the wall while you're here to use throughout your trip. Then you can just plug the USB part into the European charger. So they also have ones that have like multiple USB holes, I guess you call them, in one charger, so you can charge multiple devices at once, which is pretty cool. And I think they sell those in most electronic stores. So my advice for chargers, for like USB kind of charging devices, is just to get one of these ends and use it for your all your devices in one. The other thing though, if you have a computer, obviously that won't work with a computer. If you have a computer with you, you're gonna need one of these bigger adapters here. I use this exact one for my computer. It's quite small, packs up easily. I think I actually got it at the airport many years ago, but it's just looks like that. So they kind of, it's international, so it has a bunch of different plugins to go into the European outlets here. So if you have a computer, bring the bigger adapter. If you have just smaller devices, one of these kind of end pieces will do, and then you can just switch in and out your devices. One thing I would not suggest bringing is a hair straightening iron, unless it's a European one already, because from other countries, it just doesn't convert well. Even with like one of these adapters, It will likely burn out. So just leave this at home. You can buy a cheap one here if you really, really need it. They have them at many stores in the mall and you can get them really inexpensively these days. But don't bring yours from home because it probably will break in the outlets here. Okay, next thing is footwear. Don't forget to bring really comfortable shoes for walking. I usually get by just with some sandals for walking because we just, you know, are usually in the cities, but if you're gonna go to the national parks or something like that, then maybe pack like, you know, a better pair of shoes for walking. But as long as your sandals are comfortable and they're not gonna give you blisters, these ones I've been wearing now for a few years and they're just the most comfortable things. So just some flat sandals for me, they work really well. But of course, you choose the footwear that works well for you. Other sandals that I have, so Croatia has mainly rocky, pebbly beaches, not sandy beaches. So to go in and out of the water, either a pair of water shoes, which a lot of people don't find very attractive, or you can just get like a good pair of sandals. So I've been using these things for years already and they're the best sandals ever. They're just kind of like a rubbery whatever, but they go in and out of the sea every year. I don't know what brand they are actually, but they're just have lasted so long. Walkie. I got them for like 50 kunas a few years ago, which is like 10 Canadian dollars. And they're just really comfortable and really durable. So just get yourself a good pair of sandals to walk in and out of the sea with, or a pair of water shoes. I know a lot of people aren't fond of water shoes, so this is an alternative. One more pair of footwear. Flip-flops. You might want some flip-flops just to hang around, walk around town. If you're a Hajduk fan, these might work for you. Even he wanted me to include these, so bring some Hajduk flip-flops. Okay, what is next? Okay, I always just like to bring a bunch of headbands because they're just super easy to wear. You don't have to do your hair, just put a headband in and you're done, which is really simple and great. Next thing on the list is your bathing suit. Do not forget your bathing suit because Croatia has the most beautiful sea in the whole world and you'll definitely go swimming a lot because the water is great. Also with that, I would recommend just packing a towel for any kind of like excursions, boating excursions, or I don't know, a day at the beach. If you're staying at a hotel, the hotel will have towels, I'm sure, for the beach. But if you're staying like at an apartment or something, maybe just bring like a beach towel. They have some really great like microfiber towels that pack up really small these days. I don't have one, but I've seen them and I think they're great for traveling. Since we're here and we just drive to the coast, we don't really worry too much about how much we're bringing just because we throw it all in the car. But if you're coming from overseas on a plane, of course, you have to keep that in mind. So I've seen those really small microfiber towels that just kind of pack up tiny, but then they expand to a good towel size. So that might be a good idea to pack with you, just so you have something to bring with you when you're on the water or just by the beach. Okay, next on the list. You might wanna bring your own like Advil or Tylenol, some kind of pain, fever reducing medicine, just because you can't get it as easily here. I mean, you can go in any pharmacy and get it, but you can't get it at like a grocery store or something. So for convenience, I might suggest just bringing your own from home. The equivalent here, if you do need to get it, the ibuprofen we use, Naofen, so that's just same kind of thing as Advil. And then same thing as Tylenol would be Lupocet, that's paracetamol. So you can get it here, no problem, but you just have to go to a pharmacy to get it. And if it's after hours or on Sunday, it might be hard to find a pharmacy. So I would suggest bringing your own from home, but not required. You can definitely get it here. And there are after hours pharmacies where you can go to. They're just a bit harder to locate. And also if you're on like a small island or in some smaller village, it just might be hard to locate a pharmacy. So my suggestion would just be to bring some pain relief medication in case you need it. Hopefully you won't need it, but at least you'll have it if you do. Another thing that a lot of our guests ask us is about money and what to bring, how much to bring, are euros accepted? So right now in 2022, kuna is the only officially accepted currency. But as of January 2023, the euro will be the official currency in Croatia. So if you're coming this year, you can only pay in kunas. But as of the new year, you'll be able to pay in euro. So about how much to bring. A lot of restaurants and stores, the majority of them now accept credit cards. So that makes things easy. You don't have to bring a ton of cash. You can easily use your card to pay for things. But there are a lot of places that are still cash only. For example, bakeries, a lot of them are cash only and there are a ton of bakeries around Croatia. You should definitely go in and try as much as you can from the bakery. But a lot of them are cash only. Some of them are starting to accept cards now, which is nice, but a lot of them are just cash. Another thing for cash only is tipping. You can't really leave tips with credit cards here in Croatia at restaurants. You can pay for your meal with a credit card, but tipping has to be done extra in cash. You can't just tab it onto your credit card bill like you can, say, back in North America. Another thing that's cash only are a lot of cafes. If you go sit for coffee or have a drink, a lot of the time they're cash only as well. So there are little things here and there that you won't be able to pay for with credit card, but the majority of stuff you should be able to pay for with your credit card. So my suggestion would be to bring some cash, but don't overdo it and use your card when you can. For cash, a couple recommendations. So if you bring kuna directly from home and you get it from your bank at home, that's great. If you bring dollars with you over here, you can definitely exchange them at the exchange offices. But I wouldn't recommend exchanging them at the airport because you just won't get the best rates there. And also, they have a lot of exchange offices in the city centers, and you also might not get the best rates there either. So our suggestion would be maybe to pop into a local bank because you're likely to get better rates there. The other option is, of course, to go to an ATM. There are ATMs scattered all over every city. You'll, of course, pay a fee, but that's a really convenient way of getting kuna, just by putting your card in and pulling out kuna. So that'll work too. So yeah, that's my advice around money. Hopefully it's helpful. One last thing not to forget is, of course, your passport and your other travel documents. Don't forget those, very important. But one really cool note is that in January of 2023, Croatia will be part of the Schengen zone, which means there will no longer be borders between Croatia and other EU members that are also part of the Schengen zone. But keep in mind that if you're going to take a day trip to another country surrounding, like Bosnia, Serbia, or Montenegro, you'll still cross a border and you'll need your passport to do that. So don't forget your passports on those days if you have any day trips to surrounding countries. One last thing is that if you do forget anything, you can buy pretty much everything here, so don't worry. There are plenty of shops and stores and everything around, and so you're not going to be without. Everything I just packed here can easily be found at stores around the country, so don't worry too much. If you forget something, you can get it here. Try to pack as light as possible so you're not lugging around too much luggage. It'll just make your time easier and a little bit less stressful, I think, with less luggage. So yeah, pack as light as you can. And if you need anything while you're here, you can always pick it up here. Thank you so much for watching our video, and we hope you found it helpful. Please let me know down below if I forgot something major or anything at all, really. I'd love to hear it, and it'd be helpful for other viewers to see some other things I may have forgotten. So leave a comment below. And thank you again so much for watching, and we hope to see you again soon. All right, well, that's it. I'm off to the coast. Bye, guys.